everything seems okay, babe. You wake up and find that you're alone, 'cause I'll be gone. Street, baby, will ask you why you're walking all alone and why you're on your own. And just say I'm gone, 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 'cause you done me wrong.
To get back here in my chair.
You say that every week, but you've never fallen down, so.
Well, you just, wait, now you jinxed me. Hello, Gina.
And I'm Tyler.
This is a spotlight.
And there was a little bit of confusion in wardrobe tonight on what group we were having on. I was under the influence that we had the travel and tourism group.
Really? But
Gina actually showed up in golf pants.
So, well,
can we look at your golf pants?
I don't know now.
So, I thought maybe the golf...
It's not the golf club? It's not? I thought we were golfing. I practiced my swing. Four! No, I'm just
that
kidding.
Was more of a baseball swing, Gina.
Oh, well...
They look nice, though. I like your
golf obviously
pants.
Not a golfer.
What anyway. Are we really doing, Gina? Can we...
Travel and tourism. We have the travel and tourism club on today. We have Elaine Prelwitz, who is the president here, to speak with us. Now you guys get the full look at the golf pants, by the way.
Cherry nice. Out.
Thank you.
They look nice, don't
they,
Elaine?
I think very that nice. Golfing could be a tourist stop. People who are really into golfing travel all over just for the golf courses.
You're right.
All right. Well, anyway, hi, Elaine.
Hello.
Can you tell me what the Travel and Tourism Club does? I mean, when I think about it, I think traveling around the hills, going to sightsee.
Well, actually, what our main focus is working on resume building for tourism students who are looking for their first professional job in the field and mock interview skills, that sort of thing.
Okay, so real life skills. Do you guys do any sightseeing or anything along those lines?
Yeah, we go on trips. We recently took a trip to the Southern Hills and kind of looked at what it takes to be in the tourism industry and that sort of thing. And we're also working on fundraising to go to Yellowstone.
Okay, cool. Yeah, but
So when you say you guys do mock interviews and stuff, would you have some tips or critiques for us and our interviewing style? Are we
Possibly.
Ouch.
Oh,
I'm
no.
sure she would rip us apart.
Funny. Well, that sounds cool. I heard you a new club on campus, right? So if someone wanted to get involved and get into that, how would they do that?
Well, you can contact me at my BH email, which is Elaine Prelwitz, Elaine M. Prelwitz at BH. Or you could contact the faculty advisor, which is Dan Spencer, here on campus.
Okay, cool. Yeah, well, tourism, it's so much fun to be a tourist, you know? Who doesn't want to go and check things out? Tyler and I spent the day out sightseeing.
It was kind of a date.
No,
together.
It wasn't. No, it could have been. I mean, minus the camera following you around. I don't know how many first dates I went on with the camera, but...
It was still fun. And I tried to make a date out of it, but Gina kept slapping me, so it didn't work out for me, but...
We had a good day of travel and tourism. We're Lake Pactola today. We're going to start off our tourist day. Tyler and I were tourists today. We're going to see where we can go and what we can see, and what we can show you.
Maybe I'll go traveling for a year, finding myself or start a career. I could work for the poor, though I'm hungry for fame. We all seem so different, but we're just the same.
Homestake Mine, established in 1933, when the Confederates were actually set up to fight against the Union. And right over here was where the Battle of the Bulge was originally thought of. And then they started digging. And what are you laughing at? Do I got my history wrong?
No, you have something on your face.
Oh, okay.
Don't make me live for my Friday nights. drinking 8 pints and getting in fights.
This is the Wild Plum Fusion.
Wild Plum Fusion.
Mm-hmm. Plums and grapes.
Okay. Hold on now, you gotta swirl.
Yep, so right? You swirl, and then you look at the legs, you can kind of hold it up to the light a little bit, okay. And then sniff it, take a big aroma, and like see what you smell.
Smells good?
It
smells very good. Smells
so you can get a lot out of the aroma. So before you taste it, you smell it, because your nose senses kind of tell you how it's gonna taste.
Is it really proper to spit it after you try it?
There's certain places that do, like, if you're going to a wine tasting, there's certain like wine competitions, they'll have to taste like 50 wines in a day. It's like you don't really want to drink all the wine. So it is, you can spit, but I mean, who wants to spit good wine?
Right, I want to try it.
Should we try it?
For production here, there we've got like 1,000-gallon vats, so it in like big batches. And depending on like if they, there's dry wines that we make, like some of the, like this red wine, Three Rednecks, this is a dry wine. This one's been aged in oak for months and months. So you can see our oak barrel room over there where all those oak barrels are. Those are all full of wine. And so some of them she lets sit for a while, and then others she'll bottle right away and let them come out. So it takes anywhere from a couple months to a couple years.
Maybe I'll just fall in love. That could solve it all. Philosophers say that that's enough. There surely must be more.
Here at Flags and Wheels, we're standing next to the batting cages.
There's a lot of cool stuff to do for tourists. You can go-kart, which we're going to be doing a little bit later. So you can watch us play softball.
I don't know if you realize this, but I was all-state baseball in high school. So this is actually going to be pretty impressive.
I'm a 20-something. Let me lie in. Leave me alone. I'm a 20-something.
Are you impressed? You should be. We're gonna race.
Gina's a little nervous. She's kind of got a fear of going really fast, so we're gonna put her on and see how she does.
Yeah, maybe a little.
I'm a 20-something. Let me lie in. Leave me alone. I'm a 20-something.
But a better.